God is a God of peace. He feels the pain we feel, and He wants to take away any hurt from our lives. Because God wants us to have life in abundance, that's why He sent Jesus to come and die. Jesus says, "I've come that they may have life and have it more abundantly." God wants to see you happy and live the life of liberty that He has given to you through His Son. The Bible says, "But He was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon Him, and by His stripes we are healed." Isaiah 53 verse 5. Jesus went through all that torture for us to have peace. All our pain, sorrows, and hurts were put on Him, and He nailed it to the cross. God will put your life in order if you have faith. You shall not shed tears anymore, because there will be no reason. God will settle you with peace on every side. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. The more faith you have, the more you will receive grace and find mercy to help in times of need. You need to believe God and surrender to His will. "God, I cannot do it by myself, but I know that all things are possible for you." He says, "Behold, I am the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me?" There is nothing we give to God that He cannot fix. Then Jesus said, "Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" If you believe today, God can change your shame to glory. He can change your pain to gain. He can change your stress to strength. "I will extol you, O Lord, for you have lifted me up and have not let my foes rejoice over me." Psalms 30 verse 1. When you lift your eyes from your head and fix it on God, He will get your life together again. When the psalmist exalted the Lord in turn exalted him above his enemies. This psalm is a psalm of dedication. Have you dedicated yourself and everything about you to the Lord? When you dedicate yourself to the Lord, He will never ever let you down. "I would have fainted unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living." Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and He shall strengthen thy heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Faith will make your heart stay at the state of peaceful rest. Faith makes you courageous enough to tackle tough issues in your life. If you believe, you will see the goodness of the Lord. So when you are going through struggles, just know that it is temporary. Apostle Paul said, "Whether I live for the Lord. And whether I die to the Lord." Job said, "Even if He slays me, yet I will not let go." He also said, "When He is tried, He will come out as gold." We are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. Always carrying about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our body. When we go through tough times, it is not intended to crush us, but to make us stronger. Some things may make you perplexed, but don't let it drive you into despair. There is always hope for the one who is still alive. God has not forsaken you. God is for you. God is with you. We cannot avoid being hurt, but we can always yield ourselves to the healing process. We can choose to forgive whoever hurt us and move on instead of being under the bondage of bitterness. When you are going through pain, it is not because God has abandoned you. It is not because God no longer cares. It is not because you have sinned. But sometimes pain is a refiner that will later lead you to your gain. Some pains force us to our destiny because sometimes undue comfort is a hindrance to moving forward. Men who want to break the status quo sometimes inconvenience themselves. The intentional create situations that will force them to do what they would not have done. One can imagine how God sent his beloved son in whom he is well pleased to go through the torture of sinners just to bring redemption. God has designed every situation in our lives that they work together for our good. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Hebrews 12 verse 2. Our Lord Jesus Christ knew that the pain was leading him to his glory. He knew that weeping endures only for a night, but joy comes in the morning. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. God is producing in you something that will last forever. You will come out strong, and God will fix your life if you have faith. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him from them all. God has good plans for your life, and no matter what you are facing now, if you believe in the promises of God that never fails, God will perform every good thing in your life. When he said to Joshua to be bold and courageous, he was saying it to me and you. Be bold and courageous. Don't be afraid, neither be dismayed, because it is God who is with you. He will deliver you from anything that is happening in your life right now. Help is coming from the Lord who made heaven and earth. God is a God of peace. He feels the pain we feel, and he wants to take away any hurt from our lives. Because God wants us to have life in abundance, that's why he sent Jesus to come and die. Jesus says, I've come that they may have life and have it more abundantly. I pray that you become all that God wants you to become in Jesus' name. May you not give up regardless of the pain in Jesus' name. May God come through for you and turn your story around in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.